not the commission knows that Idaho and Italy,
yeah.
Hardwired their smart meters, so there's a direct connection rather than a wireless connection, which is often the case. REV itself is not promoting or discouraging smart meters. There are some proposals out there, and I think there's actually a demonstration plan that involves smart meters out there that will start to roll out. Those are optional at this time. But REV is not pushing that. As part of the DSIP guidance, there are some questions that the commission is asking. Because we've heard from a number of different parties some very divergent opinions about the value of smart meters. So we asked for some very detailed information in those comments about the value that they may provide and whether or not there are alternatives that can provide those values. I'm not going to do a very good job of reiterating those questions, but I do encourage you to read them and provide comments on that subject. Yes, yes, sir.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry, and I don't know if the commission knows so about Idaho and Italy. So if you want to put it on the record this afternoon, they will know.
I'm Terry.
Oh, sorry. Terry, I'm sorry.
No problem. So my name is Terry Bernardo. I'm the former chairman of the Ulster County Legislature. I only mention that because this is an issue that residents have educated me on, and I implore you to keep an open mind as I did. I'd like to refer you to and be sure that everyone is aware of the United States Department of Energy document, Smart Grid, an Introduction. Google those words and the document will come up as a PDF. It says that, quote, it provides consumers with the ability to use electricity more efficiently and provide utilities with the ability to detect problems on their system and operate them more efficiently. It talks about AMI, advanced metering infrastructure, that enables consumer-friendly concepts like prices to devices. On the face, that would seem like something everybody would want. Why wouldn't we? But here are four things that need to be discussed before we move forward. One, AMI is just another way to say smart or digital transmitting utility meters. The fact that there are Trojan meters out there in use in New York State today, that is an analog or mechanical meter on the face, concealing a transmitting meter behind. That is something that should concern everyone. It indicates deception, and it should be a crime. I strongly urge you to look into that practice. It exists. Number two, there's a growing body of research suggesting that wireless technology poses serious health risks. Headaches to infertility to cancer, restless leg syndrome. For anybody that has restless leg syndrome in bed at night, turn off your Wi-Fi. You don't need it while you're sleeping, and your restless leg syndrome will go away. It wasn't so long ago that there were television ads claiming that more doctors smoke Camel cigarettes, and tobacco companies were testifying under oath to Congress that nicotine is not addictive, something we know now is not true. Number three. Not everyone is allergic to shellfish or peanuts, but for people who are, that is quite serious. The Baby Safe Project warns about the risk to developing fetuses from exposure to wireless radiation. Many people's mothers in this room probably smoked during their pregnancy, something that we know now is not a good idea. There are people that are affected by this move to an advanced metering infrastructure, and they need to be considered in anything that is done. It affects their health. An opt-out doesn't help people who live next door to somebody who hasn't. It's the equivalent of sitting on an airplane in the non-smoking row that's right next to the smoking row. Number four and last. These meters collect data that is sold for profit. And that is an invasion of our privacy. And it is a not-so-noble benefit to the power companies that want advanced metering infrastructure. In closing, I urge you to work with the New York State Legislature to pass a New York State Consumer Health, Safety, and Privacy Protection Act. Watch the following documentaries: Generation Zapped, Take Back Your Power, Resonance Frequency of Beings. And if you're unfamiliar with what happened with nicotine, tobacco companies, and Congress, watch the movie The Insider. You want to be on the right side of this issue, not the wrong one. Thank you.
Thank you.
I seen a five-year-old's brain at a seminar. It's thin skull with liquid. You don't want any radiation, any EMFs getting in there.
I live in Woodstock, New York. Earlier this evening, I heard the speaker who was up in the front of the room answering questions state that the Public Service Commission was considering using smart meters. I'd like to say that I don't believe that's true. What I do believe is true is that it's gone way beyond consideration and the plan is in place to do this. They're already moving forward at a very rapid pace of installing these smart meters all over the Hudson Valley. The first thing I'd like to do is read the Public Service Commission's mission statement that I downloaded today from the internet. The mission statement of the Public Service Commission reads, "The primary vision of the New York State Department of Public Service is to ensure affordable, safe, secure, and reliable access to electric, gas, steam, telecommunications, and water services for New York State's residential and business consumers while protecting the natural environment." I'd like to address what that statement says and what I believe is true. Affordable for whom? It's a proven fact that once smart meters and other types of digital meters are installed on homes and businesses, that utility bills double and triple. There's testimony around the world to this effect. Safe? For whom are they safe? It is proven fact that smart meters, which are two-way communicating devices and emit pulsing microwave radiation, are certainly far from safe. The Public Service Commission has been well informed and will be held accountable. It may be prudent to err on the side of caution and for the Public Service Commission to stand up for the people. After all, your organization is called the Public Service Commission. Secure? For whom is it secure? Should we, the customer, feel secure about the ability of these meters to collect data in the privacy of our own homes and businesses, so that this data can then be stored in remote facilities? Can you deny that it has been proven in a court of law that such data has been shared with third-party marketers? Reliable access, for whom? I would partially agree with this statement, given the fact that those who consider themselves hackers will have much more reliable access to everyone's data who owns a smart meter. Is the Public Service Commission choosing to ignore the fact that these meters are easily hackable and that this has been proven and documented? Entire cities could conceivably have their electricity, gas, or water shut off by hackers. Protecting the natural environment. It's astounding to me that the Public Service Commission has made this claim. The action of installing smart meters will not help to protect our environment. If the Public Service Commission allows the installation of smart meters on the majority of homes and businesses, massive amounts of pulsing microwave radiation will be spewed into our environment. This will surely contribute to causing negative health effects for all species.
Final questions, Madam, please. You can submit your written comments to me.
I would now like to quote a fellow activist who submitted these questions to the Public Service Commission over 2 years ago. Do we, the people who pay for utility service, have rights? Do we, the customer, have a right to say no to the installation of smart meters? Are we being forced to choose between our health and the right to have electricity? Do we have the right to feel safe in our own homes and businesses? Who is protecting us? Or are we being forced to protect ourselves? Is the telecommunications industry science fictional or fact? Why is the burden of proof falling upon innocent citizens?
in our right to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness? Is it being compromised if we're made sick, poor, and our privacy is being invaded from the installation of smart meters? Will the Public Service Commission supersede the rights of the United States citizens by imposing their smart meter agenda and as a guise under the REV initiative on us without our consent? Thank you.
Hi, my name is Steve Romine. I'm a Woodstock resident and Woodstock Smart Meters, Woodstock, New York. I'm speaking to the PSC's possible approval of two-way digital smart meters for deployment to attain REV's number one objective and to the health issues involved, which needs to be addressed. Almost 3 years ago, I removed the one-way transmitting digital meter off my home in Woodstock and installed an analog meter, for which action I had my electricity terminated by Central Hudson, forcing me and my partner to live off the grid. My health issues of heart palpitations, leg cramps, and severe neck pain immediately disappeared when I made the switch. My partner had a mini stroke while standing 10 feet in front of that digital meter, also has had no recurrent mini strokes since. You can't tell us that digital transmitting meters don't cause harm because we know firsthand. So now you are telling us you may plan to approve two-way smart meters in New York if the REV initiative has its way. Have you read the 2014 peer-reviewed study by Dr. Frederica Lamech, which demonstrates smart meters have a unique ability among wireless devices to make a person become electrosensitive, a condition which is irreversible? Have you read the medical award-winning Professor Martin Paul, who published his peer-reviewed study this past August that demonstrates smart meters cause widespread neuropsychiatric effects, including depression, unquote? Are you aware that the peer-reviewed studies show when mice are exposed to low-level radiation, their blood-brain barriers relax and allow toxins to enter the brain it was designed to protect, or that mice stopped reproducing after the fourth generation of being irradiated? Are you aware there are no peer-reviewed studies demonstrating smart meters are safe? You state that the FCC says these smart meters are safe. Have you then read the report by Harvard Law School Department of Ethics titled Captured Agency, demonstrating the FCC is staffed and run by the wireless industry and in collusion? We the people do not want to be bathed in unnatural, man-made, pulsing microwave radiation by the corrupt FCC's approved wireless devices. We want you to stop poisoning us with class 2B possible carcinogen, which is what is emitted from all these wireless transmitting devices. You have absolutely no right to approve devices that will transmit a neurogenotoxin into our communities and into our private living spaces, penetrating our bodies and interfering with our intricate biological systems, causing health problems. Enough with all the wireless devices. Keep New York State safe and vote no to the REV Initiative Smart Meter Program. People have spoken.
My name is Chris Finley. I'm an engineer and I'm a resident of Woodstock, New York. I would like to comment on Mr. Anthony Belsito's statement tonight that they're considering smart meters in New York. I don't see Anthony here. Maybe this should be called public, not be heard. I think it would have been only manners if he'd stayed and listened to what the public had to say, because I stayed and listened to what Mr. Belsito had to say. So in his absence, I'd like to thank him for being here. I'm from Woodstock and I'm here to support the people's resolution for an electromechanical analog utility meter opt-out with no fees. This resolution, along with over 1,000 signatures supporting it from concerned citizens in Woodstock, New York, was sent to the Public Service Commission back in June. My reason for supporting this resolution is that in 2012, the World Health Organization declared the same radiation that is emitted from my public utility meter emits a class 2B possible cause of cancer. Now, who in their right mind would want such a thing on their home when we have a perfectly healthy, productive, and efficient analog meter on our homes for many, many years? As I said, at the moment I have a Central Hudson AMR meter on my home, and at present my only choice is to have this microwave radiating emitting utility meter taken off my home by Central Hudson, but Central Hudson will charge me a $49.99 one-time fee and a $6.99 fee per month for the rest of my life if I want this microwave emitting meter taken off my home. This tariff was agreed by you, the Public Service Commission. I've got some questions for you. Why is Central Hudson charging its customers for something they don't want? I never wanted this meter in the first place in my home. Why are they charging me to remove something from my home that is causing me and my family harm, according to the World Health Organization? And why is the New York Public Service Commission allowing them to exploit its customers in this way? Surely, any amount of money to avoid harm is extortion. Central Hudson is the party that opted us in without our permission, and as such, any costs involved in opting out must belong to Central Hudson. To opt out is no choice for the many people who cannot afford to pay these extra fees. And for those who can afford to pay these fees, they will still, in many living situations like apartment dwellings, continue to get injured by the microwave radiation coming from the neighbor's AMR meter. I also believe that the costs involved in using an old analog meter may already have been baked into our rates, and to charge customers an extra fee for this same service and disguise it as an opt-out fee is at very best unethical and at its very worst illegal and discriminatory. The only safe opt-out meter for this and every other Central Hudson customer is a free analog opt-out.
Can you sum up and just find
it? Sure. Central Hudson have stated that they cannot replace ERT meters or smart meters with analog meters because they are no longer being manufactured, yet the largest utility company in the USA, the Los Angeles Department of Power and Water, continue to replace at no cost to its customers ERT and full-blown smart meters with perfectly recalibrated analog meters, but Central Hudson say they have no analog meters. Why is Central Hudson lying to us? Why do we not have the choice of having a free analog opt-out meter?
Good evening. Thank you very much for holding these hearings. They're very important. Many opinions are being expressed tonight, and it's good for all the groups to be hearing this information. And we can go back and research and further add to the public discourse. My name is Weston Blelock. I'm from Stop Smart Meters Woodstock. At tonight's REV Track 2 hearing, we are here to discuss better ways to manage energy use, especially around peak demand. Unfortunately, several proposals by the PSC support deployment of two-way smart meters to force people to better manage their peak use. We've already experienced ERTs, but the two ways promise even more serious health impacts and still higher rate payments. These new tariffs will go towards investing in the smart meter communication structure. In addition, we will have to pay for more other such upgrades as data storage, IT systems, cybersecurity, and data management controls. According to the 2014 annual report of the Office of Auditor General of Ontario, they stated it was folly to go down the smart meter road without adequate benefit cost analysis. So far, Ontario has spent $2 billion. The Auditor General report states that only 5% of the energy distributors reported some operational savings. The other 95% said that their costs had gone up. More recently, another report from Ontario said that in the 5 years since smart meters were introduced, peak prices have increased 77%. In July of this year, the New Hampshire Public Utilities Commission issued an order of notice commencing an investigation into grid modernization. In response to that order, Eversource Energy commented to intelligentutility.com on September 17, 2015, that while smart meters or AMI meters are often equated with grid modernization, Eversource does not see them as necessary. The company went on to say that it found customers are not very interested in moderating energy use based on time-varying or dynamic rates. Presently, New Yorkers pay some of the highest electric rates in the country. I suggest that the PSC and New York State-based utilities should carefully examine what transpired in Ontario and New Hampshire to ensure that our transitional power supply is not priced beyond reach of its ratepayers. Further, my vision is to establish a community shared solar system. I think the PSC needs to share its goals. I noticed that you recently have a Twitter feed on your homepage. I think that if you had an opt-in page for eBlast, that would be nice too, to share your goals with us and give localities incentives to help community-based systems flourish. In order for the power grid to move from power plant to transmission line models, we will need locally based systems that are not vulnerable to system-wide shutdown by hackers or power surges. To do this, the New York State PSC has to decentralize, and we're all in this together. Everyone needs to be engaged. Smart meters will not help. In fact, they will cost us more money and delay the inevitable move to locally owned power supply. Thanks.
Good evening. My name is Eric Holman. I live in Woodstock. The effects of global warming, the environmental changes that are coming are already here, and I advise the Commission to do whatever it can to empower local, decentralized, renewable energy sources and take the power away from the large power companies, Fortis particularly. And in the interest of efficiency and distribution, please do not inflict more electromagnetic radiation upon us through smart meters. As Terry so eloquently put, we will soon find that they are the wrong way to go, and a mistake to invest in that direction. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi, thank you for sitting this long and listening to all of our testimony. My name is Liz Shapiro. I live in Woodstock, New York, and I'm a member of Smart Meters Woodstock, New York. I want to second what Chris, Raji, Steve, Randy, Terry, and others have said about smart meters. And I want to talk about something that's deeply personal and has affected me. I'm in a lot of pain about this, which is after Hurricane Irene, Central Hudson, without telling anybody, changed the meter on my neighbor's home. Her cottage is about 50 feet from mine. They didn't tell her, they didn't tell me, they didn't tell the landlords. And I started to feel the effects of the smart meter because the radiation goes right through walls. It goes through people's bodies. Her bedroom was on the other side of this meter. And she started also to feel the effects of it, but didn't know what was going on. That was in September of 2011. In April of 2012, she was in the hospital. in a life and death situation. She could not breathe. She had problems with her lungs, and she literally had to fight to stay alive. I've spoken with her since then, and she believes that sleeping and being in her bedroom on the other side of the smart meter was what basically brought her to the edge of death. I'm 50 feet from that meter, but I also started to feel the effects of the meter. It's not even on my building. I started to feel dizziness and vertigo in my kitchen particularly, which is the room that is closest to the meter. I had no idea what was going on. I thought maybe the floor was, you know, crooked, but it was the meter pulsing 24/7. I started to experience brain fog, and it was a clear, like, when that meter was put on. In retrospect, I now realize that's when these problems started to happen. My balance has been affected, and at this point in my life, I've become electrosensitive, and my entire life has been changed. I do pet sitting, and I teach piano in people's homes for a living. I cannot pet sit anymore in any home that has Wi-Fi on. People have to turn their Wi-Fi off or I can't work there. And if they have cordless phones, I ask them to disconnect them. If they have smart meters, I can't stay there very long. If I want to go visit my family or my friend and they have a smart meter or Wi-Fi, I'm now literally not sure I can go because I get really bad headaches here and dizziness and brain fog and sometimes nausea. Going to the library, just the library, a place I've loved my whole life, they have Wi-Fi there. Every single thing in my life has been affected, and I've talked to many people, some of whom understand the relationship between these meters and their health problems. Some people don't, and then when I mention it, the lights start to go off. I am advocating what others here have so eloquently said, which is that we ban these meters totally. That's it. I mean, forget the opt-out, just no meters whatsoever. I talk to people around the country, friends of mine, and they're mentioning the same thing. A friend of mine in California, his daughter and her baby and her husband were sleeping above a bank of smart meters, and she got really sick. So that's it. That's what I have to say. Thank you very much.
Thank you. It's not only your insightful comments, but your heartfelt comments. I just really appreciate you all coming out here, as does the commission. So thank you so much for being here. Thanks to our court reporter, who has worked very hard. Kari, thank you so much. Thank you to the school district for this great building, to Sharon and Charlene, our great folks from our Office of Consumer Services out front, keeping us running. And with that, good night, everyone.
Thank you.